Okay, I'm keen to ask you about the protests that we've seen this week outside at Batley Grammar School. This is after a teacher showed an offensive cartoon of the Prophet Muhammad. The school's apologised, suspended the teacher, who's now under police protection. Should teachers be allowed to show cartoons of the Prophet Muhammad?
Ha! Well, what an incredibly stupid question.
I had a different video entirely planned for this week, but was inundated with cries. Talk about Batley Grammar! Talk about the Muhammad cartoons! And I was like, really? I mean, is there anybody out there who doesn't know what I think when it comes to de facto blasphemy laws? But okay, I mean, it's no skin off my nose. So, the first thing to say is, this is not really about free speech. All right, and I'm getting a little peeved, to be honest, with broadcast media pretending otherwise. This incident is as much about free speech as the sinking of the RMS Titanic was about the iceberg. You know, you might say, why did the Titanic sink? Well, she hit the iceberg. Yeah, but why did she hit the iceberg? Right? The iceberg is what we call the proximate issue. The ultimate issue is that Captain Smith was sailing too fast, and the lookouts didn't have binoculars. That's why the Titanic sank, and the same reasoning applies here. The teacher suspended for showing a cartoon is just the proximate issue. The ultimate issue is that we have a bunch of Muslims in this country who won't integrate, and a ruling class who refuse to do anything about it. That's the malfunction. And until Sky News, talk radio, and all the rest of them understand this, we're just gonna keep hitting icebergs, right? That's just going to happen because the underlying problems aren't being addressed. Which leads me to the second point. I see little cause for optimism, I'm sorry, but the government's response has been predictably pathetic. They've just about managed to denounce the protesters. And that probably has more to do with enforcing COVID regulations than anything else. But then they wheel out Torybot 5000 in the form of the fucking housing minister here to spout absolute piffle on LBC. Just listen to this dipstick.
We need an atmosphere of respect and tolerance, and we need to be able to ensure that our teachers feel free to tackle difficult and complex issues. So I would strongly urge those people who have taken to the streets, who have protested outside the school, to dial this down and to work with the school in a productive and sensible way.
Yeah, what if tackling difficult and complex issues is what's preventing an atmosphere of respect, Robert? Because that's what they're saying. You can't teach this because it offends us. And work with them in a productive way. What, meet in the middle? Cut off his hand instead of his head. Brilliant. Thanks, Robert. Back to the maintenance centre. I mean, fucking hell. Contrast that with the French Interior Minister, who's had a baguetteful of this nonsense by now and is acting accordingly.
Des parents qui vont voir un enseignant pour leur dire vous arrêtez d'enseigner les caricatures, la liberté d'expression, demain ce sera une incrimination pénale. Et un juge pourra dire, c'est extrêmement important, un juge pourra dire si vous êtes étranger, que vous êtes condamné à ce délit, vous pouvez quitter le territoire national. Mmh,
When Samuel Paty was murdered in October last year, the cities of Montpellier and Toulouse projected the Charlie Hebdo cartoons onto their town halls in solidarity. Would a conservative mayor in this country do that? He'd sooner recite the bloody Shahada, okay? And this has got to change. It's time to adopt some courage français, a prospect which terrifies the radicals. Muslim leaders in West Yorkshire are to warn Boris Johnson that Britain risks becoming like France if the government does not insist on respect for Islam. Becoming like France, where they require you be French. Mon Dieu. Wait, you mean to tell me that if Islamic values contradict French values in France, it's Islam that's the problem? That's weird. Not so easy anymore, this Hijra business, is it, Ahmed? We're hoping the school will do the right thing and they'll set the right precedent. Because if this is the first case, which it is in this country, then it's very likely that we'll follow the route that France has taken, or other European countries, where firstly it's let's insult the prophet, then we'll start banning the burqa. We absolutely should ban the burqa, all right? In fact, if I'd been Boris Johnson, I'd have banned it there and then. I'd have yanked those Muslim leaders into my office and said, right, here's how it's gonna go. We can either become more like France or more like China. You pick, and watch the blood drain from their faces. I'd have marched down to Batley Grammar School, called detention, baked every kid a cake with a picture of Muhammad on it, and made them eat it. Well, okay, I might not have done that. But the point is, if you won't take a stand now, when a public sector worker is in hiding, a man who, by all accounts, was simply following the curriculum and has attracted near universal support, you'll never take one, okay?
James O'Brien on LBC. Call 0345 6060973.
Mohammed's in Limehouse. Mohammed, how do you teach children what blasphemy is without showing them?
Just to answer that question quickly, you don't show children child pornography to say it's wrong. You don't show adults child pornography to say it's wrong.
No, just try and answer the question, will you? It's got, don't bring child pornography into a conversation about a cartoon.
No, I'm not. I'm saying
no. You literally are. How do you teach children what blasphemy is without showing them what blasphemy is? I mean, you can describe child pornography to children if you want, but you know, that is just as gross, I imagine, as showing them. So in the context of the conversation that we're having about cartoons, how do you teach blasphemy without showing what blasphemy is?
Right, so Muhammad's first instinct is to bring up child fucking, which makes sense. After all, his namesake did fuck a child. And this may help explain the moral insanity behind the decision to then compare paedophilia to a cartoon. He doesn't get why they're in different camps. That the first involves criminal activity so disturbing that showing real pictures of it to children could scar them for life, while the second is a caricature of a funny bloke with a beard. Also, I remember studying religion at school. It was after chemistry, right? The child pornography period, however, wasn't a thing. Although, there was that math teacher.
Exactly how I said it. If something's offensive by law, if something's offensive to a culture, if something's insulting to a culture, I don't think it's necessary.
You can't do culture and law as if they're the same. So there's nothing illegal about what this teacher has done. So we can ignore child pornography immediately. Try again.
No. So what I'm saying is it allowed to why should people be allowed to insult religion?
Why should people be allowed to insult religion? Don't laugh, right? This is what we're up against. 27% of Muslims in Britain say they have some sympathy with the motives behind the attacks on Charlie Hebdo. And by attacks there, we're talking about the massacre of 12 people, all right? And in that same survey, by the way, 14% apparently said they would leave Britain and go to live in a Muslim country if they could. And there's gotta be some crossover there. Can we look into that, please? Home Office? I'd give them 50 grand to leave. Next referendum. Think about it.
Well, why should people be allowed to insult religion? Far too long Muslims have been...
It's called freedom of expression. As I mentioned earlier, there was a film mocking the Bible, which was banned at my Catholic school as recently as the 1980s. So, I'm deeply relieved that it's no longer banned. So it's not confined to Muslims. I don't want to hector the witness, but just have another crack at explaining to me how you show children what blasphemy is without showing them.
The point I'm trying to make is
I don't mind what the point you're trying to make is. I'm interested in the answer to the question that we dedicated this programme to asking.
It's exactly my point. You don't show people something that they're insulted by. You don't show them and say, oh, you're insulted by that. That's not how you teach. It's not necessary to teach children that something's wrong by showing them exactly what's wrong.
Well, you're showing them what other people find wrong, aren't you?
You wouldn't show...
So it's the curriculum in a British school. It has to be completely blind to the makeup of that class. You can't say, well, we'll have a different lesson for a classroom which is 50% Muslim, 50% agnostic, than we would for a classroom that's 20% Jewish, 20% Muslim.
I don't agree with you.
So you think we should have several tiers of education according to what religion the classroom is?
Not at all,
James. He doesn't want anybody to see the cartoon. You heard him. Why should people be allowed to insult religion, is what he said. And I love how everyone's just agreed to assign philosophical worldviews to these children. What was it Richard Dawkins used to argue again?
There is no such thing as a Christian child. There is only a child of Christian parents. Whenever you hear the phrase Christian child, or Muslim child, or Protestant child, or Catholic child, the phrase should grate like fingernails on a blackboard.
Or a whiteboard, Richard. In fact, I think that's the preferred colour now, isn't it? More efficient or something, I don't know. But the point is, they're not Muslim children. They're British children being educated and integrated into British society, which is what ideologues like this caller are actually worried about, of course, that children he claims ownership of will see cartoons of Muhammad and, given their general resilience at that age, will learn to accept them and be like, it's not that bad. And you know what? Let's say they don't deal with it, okay? Welcome to the world. Notice how nobody in this story is concerned about the students from Christian families who would have been shown examples of blasphemy in the context of the Catholic faith or whatever. No. Because everybody just assumes that they and their parents will be civilized about it. But hey ho. The soft bigotry of no expectations strikes again.
Insulting images should be shown, and it's not. Just
but they don't. They're not insulting images to the massive majority of the country, and the country's curriculum has to reflect the country's laws.
Can I please make a point on that? Blasphemous images. Muslims have made pictures of the Prophet Muhammad, peace be upon him, in the past, and it's not taken the same way as someone depicting the Prophet as a terrorist.
How do you show them the difference?
No, but in the past, Muslims have made pictures of Muhammad, and it's not been taken the same way as someone depicting the Prophet, taking vile images from Charlie Hebdo.
How do you know they're vile? How do you know that they depict a terrorist unless you've seen them? Someone could be lying to you.
What I'm saying is, if it's just a picture of the Prophet Muhammad, or someone's drawn a picture of the Prophet Muhammad, that's breaking Islamic theology. It's not particularly insulting in the same sense.
And how will you know what's been shown unless you can see it yourself?
And now we're getting down to it. James has put his finger on something there, and he doesn't articulate it properly because he's too busy being argumentative, but it's fundamental in terms of understanding the problem before us. How do you know an image is insulting to you if you haven't seen it? I.e., are you an independent mind, capable of forming individual judgments, or are you just a sheep? And if your tribe tells you something's insulting, that'll do. Don't even need to see it, mate. And me kids don't either. If somebody tells me they've seen something offensive, my first impulse is to say, well, show me it then. Let me see for myself. Thanks. Because we've all got different sensibilities, or at least that's the spirit we should be cultivating in a free society, and listen to Muhammad. Fail to connect with that point on any level. It's amazing.
Well, the person showing the image, if they show a picture of a bomb on
but how do you know? How do you know it's got a bomb on it if you haven't seen it?
No, I'm not saying that's the picture I was shown, but that's
so what
that's
are you saying?
Thing on the news. What I'm saying is that insulting images should not be shown.
Well, how do you know they're insulting if you haven't seen them?
I'm not saying it. I don't know what the teacher has shown. What I'm saying.
Okay,
is
let's
that
just focus on this. How do you know that an image is insulting if you haven't seen it?
Would you go? Well, the
don't answer a question with a question. How do you know an image is insulting if you haven't seen it?
Is the teacher not quite intelligent to know?
I'm going to keep asking you. How do you know?
How do you know
an image is insulting if you haven't seen it?
I would know. If I've seen it and it's insulting, I wouldn't share it with people.
But you're not allowed to see it.
He can't work it out because he's on Planet Islam. And on Planet Islam, you're a Muslim child. And you're offended by this. And what's more, everybody else now has to curtail their behavior to suit your feelings I've given you. We can't live with this, okay? I want to make that absolutely clear. Tolerance has its limits, and the cult-like mentality this guy is promoting here is the very negation of the Enlightenment, a negation of individuality. A negation of the idea that you have the duty, never mind the privilege, to be your own person, to pursue knowledge, to discover, to change, to grow, to take risks. It's the negation of our entire way of life. This is what people mean when they say Islam is incompatible with the modern Western world, okay? This is exactly what they mean.
No, I don't agree with you at all.
Well, it's not a question of agreeing or disagreeing. You have to tell me how you can decide whether an image is insulting if you haven't seen it.
The point I'm trying to make is
I don't care what point you're trying to make. I'm interested in... No, Mohammed, please, mate, answer the question.
If you know a percentage of your classroom has a percentage of Muslims in there, you wouldn't show an image that is insulting to them.
How do you know it's insulting if you haven't seen it?
The same way you wouldn't show images of a Jew because you'd be classed as anti-Semitic.
Well, I would. What, in a history class? How are you going to teach about Germany in the 30s without showing anti-Semitic material? How would you teach about Islamic countries today without showing anti-Semitic material? Also, we're not demonizing a whole race of people by satirizing the non-prophet Muhammad, okay? But the false equivalencies, man, they're rampant. I saw some of it on Twitter. People agreeing with the protesters, being like, oh, would you make a Jew eat a bacon sandwich then? You got me. I wouldn't do that, no. But then again, I wouldn't make a Muslim drink a pint of Stella either. We're talking about the free exchange of ideas, all right? And whether or not Islam should be uniquely protected from mockery. So try again.
So there's two things here going on. First of all, you think that Muslim children should be taught a different curriculum from non-Muslim children.
No, I didn't say that.
You did. You said if you have a... Muhammad, stop it, mate.
They shouldn't be insulted. Yes. They shouldn't be insulting.
But how do you know it's insulting if you've never seen it?
It is insulting.
It's insulting if you've never seen it?
I've seen it. I have seen it.
Right.
I have seen pictures published.
So you're allowed to see it, but the school children aren't?
No.
Well, what then?
What I'm trying to make... Well, if you're sharing images and you're showing pictures...
Who shared them with you?
I'm not saying who shared them. It's on the news, isn't it? Published on the news.
Well, so we have to shut the news down now, do we?
No, I'm not saying shut the news down.
Yeah, we do have to shut the news down. Where have you been, James? Not a single broadsheet in Britain printed the cartoons we're all discussing now. No one published the Charlie Hebdo cover after the murder of Samuel Paty. It's shameful. And these are the same people, by the way, who, during the Brexit vote, were writing articles about how the EU was some symbol of unity, right? How we're stronger together, arm in arm with our continental friends. Well, where were they exactly when the French Republic was under assault, her values trodden upon, her products subject to a racist boycott by Middle Eastern dictatorships? Did Sadiq Khan, that proud European, or any of these so-called journalists do their job and show solidarity with France when it really mattered? Give me a break. You know the answer. The hypocrisy is, it just makes my skin crawl.
I'm saying,
but you are saying don't teach it to young people.
Pictures should not be published if they're going to insult 2 billion Muslims around the world.
Well, they haven't insulted 2 billion Muslims around the world.
It has.
Okay.
It has.
All right.
It has.
Yeah.
And now we have the intimidation, right? The cheap mobster's trick of, look out, there's 2 billion of us, and we're all offended. There's something similar in that letter to Boris Johnson, right? All we ask is for a bit of respect. If one teacher can do it, another teacher can do it 5 years down the line, and we do not want this to be the case. Otherwise, we are not responsible for the actions of some individuals, so kindly accept our offer that you can't refuse. Right, it's practically that. I mean, what self-respecting world leader would be spoken to like this, I ask you? And also, notice how when they generalize, it's fine. Yeah? If I said 2 billion Muslims are all smelly, cousin-shagging terrorists, he'd be annoyed, quite rightly, and yet gives himself carte blanche to just decree that every Muslim agrees with him, which we know is untrue. Right? 20% of British Muslims, at least, don't find Muhammad cartoons particularly offensive, and even more, surely, wouldn't object to them being printed. Mapping these figures onto the wider world translates to tens of millions of people. So why don't we just say, these Muslims share a broad basis of compatibility with our societies, so we're going to treat them as representative of the religion, and the rest of you can fuck off, okay? Stay in your sand caves. You're not welcome. Mi casa, mi casa.
So, last chance, how do you know it's insulting if you've never seen it?
I think you're missing the point, mate. I really think you're missing the point.
Okay, what point am I missing, mate?
What I'm saying is that if you're an intelligent teacher in a class and you know these pictures are insulting, why would you show them to a group of children who believe in the faith and they're showing
so that the children could decide whether or not they're insulting or not, mate? That's the point, mate.
You've missed the point.
Mate.
You've really, really missed the point.
Yeah, what's the point again?
It's an insulting image.
How do you know it's insulting if you've never seen it?
Well, it was published in the Charlie Hebdo magazine, right?
But the children at the school in Batley probably don't subscribe to Charlie Hebdo magazine, so if you're trying to describe the story to them about this picture, how do you do it without showing them the picture?
You wouldn't show them the picture because it's insulting.
But
he did
show them the picture.
To the Muslim.
How do they know it's insulting
Muslim,
until they've seen it?
If they know there's a picture of the Prophet Muhammad that was published in the Charlie Hebdo magazine that had a bomb that depicted him with a bomb on his head.
How do you know it was a bomb, sir? Published... Can I have a look, please?
That's a different story, then, isn't it?
How do you know it was a bomb, sir? Can I have a look, please? Can we see it ourselves, sir, please?
You can go on and on and on, mate, but what I'm saying is you don't insult a community by showing an image that's known to be insulting to that community.
And it's 12:45.
Coming up at 1, Sheila Fogarty.
Well, that was a shit show. And notice how there's no breaking through, right? You're talking to somebody who is incapable of understanding where you're coming from. And this is the challenge we face in the West right now. How do we communicate with these people? Answer? I don't think we can. I'm sorry, but there it is. And I never thought I'd be doing a video supporting James O'Brien, for God's sake. What has happened to the world? Actually, next week, I'm doing a video criticizing Christopher Hitchens. So this must be the end times. The earth is about to be showered in fire and flame. But look, when you're right, you're right. And when you're wrong, you're wrong. It's as simple as that. And unlike Muhammad, I think for myself and encourage you all to do the same. Now, in the end, you'll realise I'm right, of course. And in the end, Boris Johnson will realise that Emmanuel Macron, his French counterpart, is right. Because, as I said at the outset, this is far wider than free speech. Every civil liberty is on the line here. The type of Muslim protesting outside that school would institute Sharia in a heartbeat. And Macron understands this now. In fact, I tweeted out the other day that I was moving to France, and it's tempting, I gotta say. I mean, when you hear their centrist, quasi-socialist president speaking solidly on this, it does suggest that at least one country in Western Europe has some fight in her, and might yet save itself from the folly of former policies. À la semaine prochaine.
Parce que je suis lucide sur notre situation. Quand j'ai parlé d'un séparatisme, qu'est-ce que ça veut dire et pourquoi ça correspond à ce que je vous décrivais tout à l'heure? Parce que vous avez des groupes, que j'appelle ces extrémistes violents qui agissent au nom de l'islam et en détournant la religion, qui enseignent, expliquent dans le cadre d'associations, en utilisant toutes les libertés et les droits que la République offre, que notre pays offre. Ils enseignent qu'il ne faut pas respecter la France, qu'il ne faut pas respecter notre droit, qu'il faut en quelque sorte sortir de nos lois. Ils enseignent que les femmes ne sont pas l'égale des hommes. Ils enseignent que les petites filles ne doivent pas avoir les mêmes droits que les petits garçons. Pas chez nous. Je vous le dis très clairement. Pas chez nous. Nous, nous croyons dans les Lumières. Et les citoyennes ont les mêmes droits que les citoyens. C'est existentiel. Et donc, jamais, 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 je n'accepterai une association, quand bien même elle le ferait au nom d'une religion, qui pousserait ses droits. En tout cas, qui dirait, une petite fille n'est pas l'équivalent d'un petit garçon. Elle n'aura pas le même enseignement, on ne lui donnera pas les mêmes chances. Parce que ça n'est pas notre droit. Les gens qui croient ça, qu'ils aillent le faire ailleurs. Pas sur le sol français.